of dishes. Dad remembered the government sending box cars full of this poison with salt mixed with sawdust, so they could shovel it into the ditches for the grasshoppers and stuff. And then they used, he said he remembered using formaldehyde as fertilizer. Yeah.
Oh.
He said they didn't have toys when they were little, but Uncle Joe and Uncle Chris and Dad would make toys out of twigs, and they carve, you know, trucks and stuff out of hunks of wood and stuff. My dad was loved by so many. He gave away two of his sisters at their wedding. Auntie Dot was one. Yeah, and Auntie Josie. He was godfather to numerous nieces and nephews. He was a dad, you know, to us, but he was a dad to so many. He was a friend and a brother to countless people. He was a mentor to so many. With a, you know, he had a grade 7 education because he had had to quit school, but he became a very successful businessman, and he sold the plant and retired when he was 55. They spent the summers at East Trout Lake and their winters in Mexico. And you know, regardless of the trials and tribulations that my mom and dad had, they persevered and had a beautiful life, and they gave us three kids a beautiful life and tons of happy, happy memories. Dad had been, he was in a car accident when he was 30, and so he had, or in his 30s, and so he had chronic pain his whole life. And then there was, you know, other injuries, and there was other accidents, and he said he never remembered a day without pain. And you know, we really, really learned from that, that he accepted this with so much grace, and we just learned from that tolerance, acceptance, and perseverance. And so brought a few dadisms.